Hi, everyone. I will not practice my poor Portuguese today, so we'll do it in English. Primarily, I will focus on competition, evolution of competition in the market. Do it quick because we are running out of time. Just make sure that... Are we changing slides? Right, okay. Technology. First, just a snapshot of the competitors today, the players in the market. Clearly, we have two sides, the concessionaires and the new entrants. Concessionaries today are playing a private monopoly in their respective region, oligopoly when it takes the entire market. Primarily, when you add to that that they have the non-compete clause between themselves, you know, at least the behavior is a non-compete behavior, and that's creating that kind of oligopoly in the market. I believe that sooner than later they will have to compete between each other, and we'll talk about the new drivers that will change competition in the market, or they will have to consolidate, as some of them already mentioning. With respect to the new entrants, clearly we had the boom, then we had the bubble, yes, and today we have more stability with some players that still have been able to survive the bubble. I believe that, and we'll talk about this in a minute, there are new drivers that will enforce new model of competition and will change probably and give us the rebound that we are looking for a long time. Again, when it comes to new entrants, it's important to emphasize that it's not only the regulatory model that is to be blamed. Of course, clearly it's importance and necessity, but importance for all new entrants to have the right business model, strategy, executions, funding, scale, and so on. And it's really a combination of both regulations and business model to be able to be successful. Of course, when you look on the market itself, it's very important to differentiate between the corporate market and residential and SMEs. On the corporate market, clearly we have full-blown competitions in all vertical segments from local, long distance, VoIP, and so on. When it comes to the residential SMEs market, there are, I think, two different markets. The one, region two, which GBT is participant there, I think we have clearly a competition in local markets. It's listed in the 54 cities that GBT is a player. When it comes to region one and three, when in my opinion there's no alternative carrier to Telemar and Telefonica, there is really none or very little competitions on the local markets. In addition, I will emphasize that even in the long distance, there's no really competition. I think it's a weak competition despite what people think, because of the competition is on the brand, not on prices. Still, consumer paying 65 centavos to call to New York, 35 to 40 centavos to call domestic calls, while at least GBT charging 17 centavos between Curitiba to Tokyo. So you can see that even in long distance, there's no real competition, and even there, the incumbents are not competing against each other. So I think the consequences of lack of competition is much above the cost to the economy, which I estimate the extra charges due to lack of competition by about 5 to 6 billion reais a year. I believe there's also consequences to the industry itself. First, the public opinion is very strong against the fixed telephony sector. I think we are popular almost like the Argentinian football team. Second, we are losing a lot of consumers to cellular, Skype, free VoIP, and so on, which is bad to the industry because the prices are forcing them outside of the sector. And third, a lack of innovation leading clearly to lack of new features and innovations in that sector. And I think that's why we see very little growth in lines in service, very little growth in the industry itself. So all of us paying a price of lack of competition, including the concessionaires, even if they don't realize it. Innovation is critical for newcomers. I think you have to have a value proposition that had innovation. GBT has a lot of that kind of value proposition in different segments, but I will not, of course, lack of time to talk in each one of them, but I think even if you take one of them, that is the detailed local calls in the bills, that it's still shocking that in 2005, none of the concessionaries offering a detailed local bills, so people don't know for what they are paying, to whom they call, and so on. Of course, in GBT is part of the offering. We have a lot of products like Economics and Unique that are bundled of and pooling of minutes that really giving a 30 to 50% discount for customers on prices. And we have the VoIP, which is we launched last year, and this year we are launching a new version that is more fit to compete with Skype kind of VoIP than with the traditional PSTN. We'll offer hundreds of local areas in one line and free VoIP to VoIP calls. So that will come in September. And of course, we are planning to develop and launch WiMAX as soon as possible. So that's the kind of innovation that new entrants can bring to the market and trigger the dynamic that is needed. The incumbents also has their own innovations, of course, like this one. You can see when you have a monopoly power, you can see that they found a loophole in regulation that enabled them to differentiate between the indexation of pulses versus the asintura basica, the monthly fees. So if you look on the chart, you can see that the asintura basica is about 15% higher than the IGPDI, while pulses is lower in order to get the basket right. So that's the way when you have monopoly, they can abuse their power to that level, having customers paying much more than they needed for the fixed cost, the monthly fees versus the pulses, the usage. On the other end, when you look on a competitive market, that's a survey that's been done by a research company in 2003, you can see that in markets, when there is no competition, like Salvador, Sao Paulo, and Rio de Janeiro, more than 50%, so around 50%, say to the questions, do you have any operator that respect you? 50% said there's none. In Curitiba, when there is competition, again, we saw that only 20-something percent said that there's no operating respecting them. That's due to the fact that GPT is a player in Curitiba. At that time, we had only 12% market share, and 28 said that GPT respecting them, although we've been much smaller at the time. Today, we have 20%. So I think customers, when there is competition, recognizing the benefits. Again, talking now about the future, I think there are new drivers that will lead to major changes in the competitive landscape. Many of the people talking the last 2 days about new technologies, the new consumer, in my opinion, there's a new consumer today. There's new players that come into the market and hopefully new regulations that can help to support those drivers. First, of course, I will skip WiMAX is a big promise to with respect to last mile, wireless broadband wireless, and of course it will add other more features. VoIP is not just a substitute for cheap long distance. VoIP as a product, as a feature, as a technology is a much superior telephone line than traditional telephone line, and companies that we know how to leverage on that will be able to compete not just head to head competing on the same service, but offering a superior service to the traditional PSTN line. Triple play, I believe, is a dream for the next year and a half. People talking about this, no doubt 2007 and 8 will be more realistic scenario. The new consumers is more and less tolerance for high prices and bad quality, so is smarter than we used to see 2-3 years ago. He knows to find the ways to find the right communications equipment, if it's cellular or VoIP. Also, there's no barriers anymore, physical barriers, geographical barriers. GPT has customers today in Australia, in Germany, in Japan, and in the U.S. because of the VoIP. You don't have barriers, so I think it's increasing the addressable market of newcomers, and that's a big chance for new players. We have also new players like cable TV, ISPs, and others that no doubt adding now offering telecom services, offering new dynamic to the market. In the end, regulatory is a must. Without all that new regulation that is critically required, none of those drivers will be effective. Primarily, I think we need to have asymmetric regulations on interconnection. We need to have asymmetric regulations on frequencies for WiMAX. WiMAX can still stay a big promise unless Anatel will give asymmetric allocation of frequencies to new entrants. From all the list of the traditional issues, unbundling and so on, I think non-portability is the most critical one and more immediate one, especially when the cost is not more than 2 reais per user. We should have Anatel regulated as soon as possible. And on the new technologies, no doubt that Anatel has to make sure that VoIP will have its own space without any regulation that will block that development. And on WiMAX, the same allocation of frequencies is critical for the development of the technology. Thank you very much.
Just 1 minute to conclude, sure. Please. One minute.
I'm finishing. So just in summary, competition is viable, but we need for that, you know, the players to do their own business model right and take, you know, the accelerating deployment of new technologies. The regulator has a major role in making it happen. Thank you.
Muito obrigado.